Peters has basically said that you've betrayed him.
Yes, he's also said that we told him that we would support him through this judicial process. That is, like, we would vote in his favour, and that is absolutely not correct.
Was he expecting you effectively to sabotage the political process as other parties have done?
Well, you know, I might be naive, but I thought that was a sort of a really proper official committee, like a court, the highest court in the land, in fact. Mm. And I heard Dr. Cullen compliment Mr. Power on his chairing, that everything was fair and evidence was heard. So, you know, when you are rung up and spoken to about which way you go and it may be repercussions, one has to think, is it a court or not a court?
All right. Well, let's move away from Winston Peters now, because, I mean, to cut him a bit of slack, I suppose his back's against the wall, isn't it? And so he was asking for favours from you.
Yeah, but you can say move away, but the point is, once someone violates your trust, you know, where do you go from there? Because we have done nothing but support that man, and I'm really disappointed that he's turned against us.
Yeah, and I'm sure you are, but then, you know, he's turned against a few, hasn't he? And his back is against the wall, so I suppose attack is another form of defence. But let's talk about a different kind of attack from Labor to the Māori Party, Parakura Horomia's conversation with you. Can you just tell us what exactly did he say to you?
I want to be very clear here. Parakura and I talk about so many things, and we work together on many projects. And Parakura, I know he meant no harm, but on top of the, he did ring me twice, and we did talk about the decision. And the second time, he mentioned possible repercussions from our people should we not support Winston. And that's fine in itself, but I just seem wrong in terms of, is this a court hearing or not a court hearing? But coupled with the meeting, which I think was more sinister, of a very senior staff member of New Zealand First insisting on a meeting with Te Rūro Flavel and Te Rūro honouring that, and then spending some time to try and get him to vote in accord with New Zealand First, I think that was the worst part.
So are these people trying to pervert the course of justice? Clearly they are.
In my mind, if that committee and that court is about justice, then of course, yes.
Well, so in reality, it's a joke, the Privileges Committee, isn't it? I mean, what's happened here is an absolute joke that we're having to pay a fortune for.
Yeah, well, I hope it isn't, you know, and that's what shocked me, really. And I see the clerk of the parliament has come out and said that this is common to lobby at that level, and I just think it's wrong. If you lobby, why call it a court?
Well, exactly. I mean, it isn't common to lobby in court of law. In fact, that is against the law, isn't it?
That's right. Well, she's saying that there's no offence and MPs are entitled to lobby over the Privileges Committee procedures.
Yeah, well, that's ludicrous. You know Parakura very well. In fact, you've just said that you have regular
friends.
Conversations with him.
Yep.
So does this come out of his own mind? Does he think, oh, I might go and put a bit of pressure on me old mate Pita Sharples, or do you think this is Helen Clark telling Parakura to do it?
Well, I believe it's the government, because Dr. Cullen has made a few off-the-cuff sinister remarks to me personally and about the whole affair. Shane Jones has spoken out very loud about us betraying Māori and things like this. I just find it really crazy that both Shane Jones and Winston want to lock up gangs, whether they're a criminal or not, and yet here's a judicial procedure where you find somebody has perhaps breached procedures and they want him let off because he's a Māori. And there's a bit of a conflict there, surely.
Can you give me an example of one of Michael Cullen's sinister comments to you?
Oh, just the remarks like when I sat in on a committee meeting for Te Rūro, and he says, yes, you should have sat in on the Privileges Committee. I said, you know, just remarks like that. I'm sitting in for Te Rūro Flavel. You should have sat in on the Privileges Committee. Things like that, you know.
I mean, are these the sorts of people that, assuming they're moderately successful at the election, you'd want to do a deal with?
Oh, exactly, and that's how I'm beginning to think. I mean, you know, maybe I shouldn't be in there, but, you know, I don't know of that kind of pressure and that kind of way of dealing with people anywhere else.
You know, there's a huge number of, I mean, we get a lot of feedback here, and I'm suspecting you probably get this from your constituency as well, from people who say, would you just run the blooming country? You know, here you are fighting over these tiny things that cost us a fortune. Who is actually running the country?
And it gets quite pathetic at times, and there's quite a number of us in there who've tried to establish a code of conduct so that this tit-for-tat abuse, really, of each other stops, and it takes up the whole of question time sometimes. And people say, well, that's the way of the house. Well, it needn't be.
Is it insulting to Māori people to suggest that they would support Winston come hell or high water just because he's a Māori?
No, it's not insulting, because that's what we do. And that's why we went to some lengths. Both Tariana and I rang Winston and told him, you know, hang tough there and get through this. But it didn't mean to say that, and when we're asked, as I said, we spoke about his good points. It didn't mean to say we have to pervert the course of justice or change our view because he's a Māori. But no, Māori always support their own when they're down, and I expect he'll win quite a bit of support over this. I just hope people can realise that there's something called integrity that's more important.
Well, but effectively, that is what Parakura Horomia is saying to you, that it could hurt your party because Māori will say, well, they're our own people and they didn't support Winston Peters.
That's right, and I think Parakura was being a realist. I mean, he could see that possibility, and he was just pointing that out to me. You know, I have no beef with Parakura whatsoever. I don't think, you know, because that's how we do. We warn each other, suggest things to each other. Nevertheless, it from my context of this is a court hearing, you don't interfere with with what's going on. I found it out of order. But it seems that the clerk of the court thinks it was okay, so fine.
Have the Labor Party behaved shamefully over this affair?
I think that they still are, in the sense that they've rubbished the whole procedure, which was really, it took a lot of time from Te Rūrof level. He gave a lot of time, he gave very serious consideration, and in his speech in the House where he outlined why he reached his decision, we've had so much good feedback about that speech and thanking him for the clarity of his exposition.
What's your advice to Winston?
My advice to Winston is to, you know, stop attacking people just to gain political advantage and, you know, square up and stand on his merit of what he's done.
Do you want another term in Parliament yourself?
Well, one wonders after things like this, but, yeah, I'm back.
All right. Peter Sharples, thank you very much for joining us. And sure. Also, thank you for showing a bit of integrity. At least the whole Privileges Committee thing with Winston hasn't been a complete waste of our money. All right, if you've got a view on this or anything else we mentioned this morning, do drop us a line. We would love to hear from you, find out what you think. Even people who don't really think send in texts sometimes, and it's amusing. You can text us on BF, leave a space, and then send your message to 8850. You can email us breakfast@tvnz.co.nz.